No! I'm supposed to help with the redstone. Come on, the channel's named after you.
Hello, everybody. Pug Nation here. Welcome back to another episode of Pug's Quest. In the last episode, we started our rail line, and I went ahead and off camera finished it up. It now goes into that mountain. I'll show you that in a second. And I think in this episode, we should start building a sweet automatic, not automatic, but like a cool rail station inside. Because what I imagine is having a rail hub inside this mountain here where that goes, which I will show you in a second. And you'll be able to have like, I'm gonna have like a local line. I'm gonna call it the local for all you city folk out there. It'll take you areas around this island and areas close by, like eventually to the original spawn point in the server, which is over there. I'm also gonna have my nether portal in there for long distance express travel. But we need to gather some materials. Let's plant more crops just to keep that going. So I don't starve to death, but we need to chop down some trees, get some wood, and I got a real cool design for you. It uses memory cells, so there's like a little, not much, but a little bit of redstone going on in this episode. Little bit of redstone. So stay tuned for that. Should be cool. Let's start chopping down some trees, getting some sand to make glass. I think glass will be in this design as well. And yeah, it's going to be pretty sweet. I'm really excited for this. I need to start getting some the new snapshot. Have y'all seen it yet? There's like banners now. Have you seen how cool banners are? If not, you really need to check it out. Wool is of course a big part of that design. So are dyes and stuff. So going to need to start some kind of wool operation so I could start building with that, which I want to anyways, because wool I think is a really cool material to build with. You could do lots of cool things with it. But let's just go ahead, get some wood here. First things first, get this rail station set up. Really excited about this build. Gonna be sweet! Gonna be sweet. I got a buddy. His name is MusicSim8 on the server. It's actually his server. I'm actually on his server. And he started to record videos. So those will be coming out soon. And hopefully we'll be doing some videos together. I know I said originally that this would mostly be a single player. Maybe completely a single player let's play. But I lied a little bit. Hopefully we'll be doing some collaboration videos soon. Hopefully very soon. And 1.8 hopefully will be coming out soon. I think we're going to get the snapshots on this server pretty soon. Hopefully very soon. Which is kind of problematic because there's lots of new blocks in the snapshot. And I've already loaded this area of the map. So I'm going to have to go really far away in order for those new blocks to load. Which is fine. That's just more of a reason to get the nether rail up, because of course you could travel 8 times faster in the nether, and if I need to go really far away to get those new blocks to load, doing it in the nether would take half the time, or actually 1/8 of the time. So definitely need to get this transportation hub up and running. Let's just keep chopping down wood. Give me that back. Dump some of this crap that I don't need. I don't need all that dirt. But all right, I'm going to keep chopping down some trees, and then I will meet you in the mountain so we can actually get started with this build. All right, guys, I told you in the last episode I might finish this off camera. I went ahead and did that, but check out this ride. This part is all new. All right, pretty sweet. What do you think of that? How do I get out of this? Oh my gosh. All right, so that's pretty sweet. This is what I have in mind for the rail station. You can hit a button. It'll switch on a memory cell. It'll switch a track over, and then it will select that destination. That's a terrible explanation. Basically, it's a rail station where you could select a multitude of different destinations with the push of a button, and then you just put your cart in. And off you go. So you'll see basically all this does is if you hit this button, the red light turns on, indicating that that destination has been selected, and this switches over. And then to unswitch it, just hit that button, and it switches back. Let's see if I can get that shot. Whoop. And whoop. Kind of hard to see, but you'll see how it's going to work. It's going to be friggin' sweet. Really excited about it. All right. let's get started. Probably gonna have to think about this quite a bit, but for now I'm just gonna get kind of the guts in. The guts meaning the working parts, and then I will work on making it beautiful later. But for now, I just want it to be functional. So this is destination one, will be the little house where I'm doing all my farming. That's destination number one. And we could throw in a bunch of other destinations like this. That's destination two, destination three, destination four, and so on. We could do as many as we want. Let's get that out of the way. Have that default correctly. Okay, so I think the carts need to default. Let's see, I figured all this out off camera. Now I'm going to have to think it through again. The carts are all going to default, or rather, you're going to start over there. Yes, that is correct. You're going to start over there, and then if you flip the switch... Man, this is tough. Okay, wait. Hold up. No, okay, you're going to start over there and then go that way. Okay, so let's just get started. You'll see this. Obviously, I can't talk. It's kind of a hard... It's hard to explain. It's kind of tough to explain. I think at the beginning of this episode, I'm going to throw like a 10-second clip so you can actually see what I'm talking about. You can actually see it instead of having me try to explain it poorly, as poorly as I am right now. Man, my inventory's full. Damn. This keeps happening to me. Let's build a chest so I could just dump some of this crap. Make this all easier for me. Let's make a double chest just for the construction. This is actually a very simple build. It's not too hard, really, is it? The redstone involved is pretty limited. You can see down there, that's pretty much the whole thing, is that little 2x3 memory cell. Very simple, and I will show you how to build that. Let me just get organized here. And I think what I'm going to have is the destination select right here. I'm going to have to find a way to hide it and a way to decorate it or whatever. But I'm going to have to put a torch under there. Redstone torch goes under each of these tracks. So let's just go ahead and do that. Redstone torch goes under every single track. That's thing one. Let's go ahead and do that. Dig out this space in front of each torch. Dig a little out like that. Oop, don't get stuck down there. Yep, like I just did. This is going to be messy, but of course I'm going to clean it up and make it all look beautiful. Don't you worry. I never leave anything a mess for long. Actually, yes, I do. But anyways, let's... eyes on the prize. Then a little bit of redstone wire. I'm going to keep looking back at this because I got to cheat. I got to remember how I did it. So I think I did 1, 2, 3. I'll just do it 2 blocks away. I'll start doing the memory cell. And for now, I'll just build it out of wood. I might change the way I do it later. So wood there. Torch on top of that. Like so. Piece of wood on top of that. Like so. None of these need to be here. Man, it's nighttime already. Put your buttons in. Doop, doop. Now this torch, you're probably thinking that's sloppy. The torch is exposed. But it has the added benefit of acting as like an indicator as to which option you have selected. Which rail line you have selected. Oh, and I put it one too wide. I'm such an idiot. Hold on. There we go. Easy fix. I don't want this here. But yeah, that redstone torch, at first it was bothering me that it was exposed, but then I was like, wait a minute, this could work to our benefit because then it lets you know if it's lit up, you have that track, you have that destination selected. So I actually really like it. It's kind of an elegant solution. And let's see, we need to put a repeater like that. This is called a memory cell. I won't claim that this is the most compact memory cell, but it's right up there. It's pretty close. It has the benefit of being only 1 block wide, which is pretty sweet. And that's it. That's a memory cell. How does this work? It's actually a T flip-flop, I think you would call this. But how this works, hit a button, the torch is on. Hit another button, torch goes off. That's it. Pretty easy. And now we're just going to vertically transmit this wire straight down, and we're just gonna connect this. This is a very simple design, guys. I told you. I was doing a terrible job explaining it, but don't worry, I didn't let you down. You know I would never let you down. Straight into that torch. And now this will have the benefit of turn it on. That should switch over. Why isn't it? Turn it off. It should switch back, but it isn't. Oh, jeez. Pugnation, what'd you do? Huh, why isn't it working? The memory cell is working. That's the hard part. Oh, it's because you don't have a dust there. Hold on. Boop. There we go. That's an easy fix. All right, let's try that again. Okay. When it's off, it's switched like that. When it's on, it switches like that. Now, if a cart is coming from this direction, you will go to that destination. Uh-huh. And I'll show you what I mean. I'll do it right now. Let's put a powered rail right there. Bloop. A clumsy explanation, but actually a pretty simple concept. I think you would agree. And it's kind of neat how it works. Let's see. Let me get my cart. Put it there. Okay. Now, if nothing is selected, you'll see I'm just going to go. Oop, I should probably get a button in here, huh? I'm just going to go straight ahead. Not going to go anywhere if nothing is selected. However, if I decide to, okay, I want to go to that destination, hit that button. Now, when I hit this button, I will go that way. Woo! And that's how it works. And I guess I'm just going to go for a ride here. All right, I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to hook up all the other memory cells. I'll cut back, and then we can decorate the thing, make it look nice and pretty. Be right back. All right, welcome back. And you can see I've made a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 destination rail hub here. And, of course, this could be as many wide as you want. It's pretty sweet, though. I'm not going to lie. Put your cart here. Select your destination. Boop, light goes on. This switches over, sit in the cart, hit the button, and away we go. Now, there's one problem I have to fix. When you're arriving, if you leave one of these buttons pressed when you arrive, you might, like, accidentally, let's say I'm arriving from this destination, you'll see instead of going over here to where I want you to arrive, instead you come back and you just get slingshotted out another destination. Do you see how that would be a problem? So I have to make a way to have all of these like reset somehow. So I think that's pretty easy. I just need to put like a detector rail and then and have that hooked up to right here. It has to trip these torches. And that's no problem. That's pretty easy to do. And that will have the benefit of as soon as you're coming in, it will reset so all these turn off. And then you will definitely go over here to the arrival section. So this is pretty friggin' sweet, don't you think? Got to put in that reset circuit. That's our last bit of redstone that we need to do. And then I'm just going to decorate the thing and make it look friggin' sweet. So you got to stay tuned for that as well. Very important. Let's see. I totally forgot how to make detector rails. Let's see. Oh, no, I did it. Ha! Pugnation. He never forgets. 6 is not enough. That's okay. One of them won't. I guess one of them won't ever reset for now. That's okay because I don't have. I made it 7 destinations, but I don't have 7 destinations to go to. As a matter of fact, I only have 1. So a little bit over the top. Oh, yeah. I had to put these powered rails here. Otherwise, every time you go through one of these switches, you slow down. So that those powered rails have to be there in order to maintain your speed. And that's very simple to do. I just put a torch under everything. So the switches still work. Hit a button, that still switches. No problem. But yep, just added those booster rails. No big deal. Let's go ahead, throw in the detector rails, and then I have to find out how I'm going to put this reset circuit together. Shouldn't it be too hard? I don't think. Going to need a bunch more. What am I going to need? I'm going to need a lot more of pretty much everything. No, I need a lot of redstone repeaters. That's right. Which is fine. Got plenty of stuff to make that with. Let's just make a bunch of repeaters. Not too many, I guess, because I'm actually pretty short on, let's see, I'm going to need more than 4. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Perfect, that should do. Bunch of redstone. Okay, I got 12 repeaters. That should be enough. Okay, now I'm just going to... This is going to be kind of more annoying than it is difficult, but I need to power that torch in order to reset the memory cell, I believe. So if the memory cell's on... Yes, providing power to that torch will fix my problem. So that's really easy to do. We'll just do this with... We'll do it with clean stone just to keep the look. I don't know how I'm going to hide this and make it look pretty. it's kind of a daunting proposition, isn't it? It's pretty big. But you know what? We're going to figure it out. I have no doubt that we're going to figure it out. Hey, if this does look intimidating to you, I would love to do a tutorial about how to do this, like a formal tutorial, if you guys would like to see that. I know in the past my tutorials have been quite popular. I would love to do that for you guys. Uh-oh, why are these all turning on? I don't want these turning on. Uh-oh. This is going to be harder than I thought. I'm breaking it by doing this. That's not what I wanted. Why is that doing that? I wonder. Why is that doing that? What is powering these? Hold on. Of course it has to be more complicated than I thought. Okay. Okay. Yeah, that's a problem. I'm going to have to think this through more. We have to have some way of resetting all these circuits, but you could see that that's not going to work because if you do leave one of these on, this brick is powered, and then it just powers all the blocks. It turns all the memory cells on, which essentially it breaks the entire purpose of the thing. So this is actually a little bit trickier than I thought it would be. It's actually a lot trickier. Maybe I could have them... Oh, that's how I'll do it. I'll have them powering this block. It's just going to make it harder to hide, though. That's all. But that's okay. That's an easy fix, too. So instead, I'll have this circuit coming right through here. And I'm just going to have to, like, put a brick in front of that to hide it. But that's no problem. I can do that. Not a problem. That's okay. Simple solution. All right. I'm going to go ahead and throw that circuit in. Or at least make some progress on it. And then I'll cut back. And I'll see you guys then. Okay, so it turns out that doesn't work either. As you can see, that's a problem. That's definitely a problem. That is not working. I don't really quite get why this isn't working. Let's see. So why does that turn on? It's because that brick is powered by that. Man, this is actually pretty tricky. This is giving me some headaches here. And it's very important, too. It's got to work. Otherwise, this whole thing's pointless. So maybe... Maybe power a torch underneath? Maybe. What does that buy us? Let's see. Can I put a torch underneath? I'm going to get this to work. Don't you worry. This is going to work. It's going to be great. I'm not going to let something this stupid defeat me. If you put a torch there. But that does that. No. Why is this so difficult? I will not be defeated. I will not be defeated by this. No, I won't. There's gotta be a way to reset this. There's gotta be a way. How about... I'm an idiot. Why don't I just connect a signal from that individually to each memory cell? Right? Would that work? Let's find out. All right, Joel. What do you think, Joel? It's the pug. What do you think? You got any advice for us? Huh? Got anything? You're so wise. Such wisdom. Stop licking my face. Stop it. You're supposed to help me with the redstone. You're not helping. No. You're supposed to help with the redstone. Come on, the channel's named after you. I can't fix it. Okay, everybody, I'm back. Wow, I think I've got an answer to it. That was really hard, actually. I had to go into creative and, like, another map, and I was screwing around, and it got really complicated. I had, like, sticky pistons and a lot of redstone going on, and it just got crazy and out of hand. You could see I flipped this 180 degrees, so now you start on that side and go out that way, and I inverted all these, and... all in the name of troubleshooting how to get this to restart, but I think I have a solution. It's not the best solution, but it works. So what I have is I have all these sensor rails hooked up to turn off this booster here. So what happens is you fly in, and all it does is it turns these off so that you stop. So no matter which way it's switched, if it switches that way, you're going to stop there. If it switches like it is now, you're going to stop there. So no matter what, no matter how these buttons are pressed, you're not going to go flying anywhere. You're going to stop automatically here. And I'll just show that in action. So right now, that one's turned on. So if you were coming in here, you should accidentally get shot out in that direction. But because the brakes are set up, and I'll come in at full speed just to demonstrate that this works, even at full speed, the brakes, it should turn on the brakes and I should stop. And I stop perfectly. And that was with me like holding down boost and trying to get the cart to go. So that's the best thing I could do. I'm sure there's a better way to do it. It would involve me modifying these memory cells, I think, but then it would be less compact, which kind of takes away some of the charm of this. So I would love to do a tutorial on this, guys, and really show off how to make it work and maybe to improve on it, but now is not the time. Now let's drop the beat and start making this beautiful. right, everybody. It looks like I'm just about out of resources. Oh, maybe not. Maybe I have enough clean stone to finish it off. But at any rate, that's enough for this episode. I think it's probably long enough. I got to work on this bottom part here, cover up the redstone. I might just wall it off with like either wood or cobble or something, just so I can't walk right into it. Kind of a weird looking design. I left this open here because I'm going to eventually make like a road from down there, so you can walk to this train station. So this is purposely open. There's going to be some kind of doorway here with stairs that you could come on in. I think this arching kind of roof thing came out pretty well. That's pretty sweet. Yeah, I really like it. It's functionally working, as you could see. I've used it a few times already, and it works perfectly. It's a pretty neat look. I mean, it's a little ugly, but that's fine. I left this like this because I think it's kind of cool to be able to see the redstone. Kind of see what's going on behind the scenes. I think that's kind of neat. Have a little like observing room here. But otherwise, guys, I'm just going to throw a roof on this. That's it. That's it. It's finally done. Or it's about done. It's close enough to done that I'm okay with it. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching this episode. Sorry that it went a little bit longer than normal. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you liked what you saw here. Let me know if you'd like to see a tutorial about how to actually build this thing a little bit more in depth, and I could definitely improve on it. Definitely, definitely, definitely can improve upon this. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I will see you all very soon.